Scene 1. Location: Little Angels High School. February 13, 2014. It was a very memorable day for me. Contest master, chief judge, and fellow Toastmasters. That was the day when I met Shravya. She was a very beautiful girl with a long blonde hair and a sweet voice calling, "Preetam." I still remember that. When I first met her, it was like magic, real magic. And her smile was the purest thing that I've ever seen till date. One day, when she was walking towards me, I wanted to talk to her and I just said hi. She was very kind and both of us have started conversing. After the conversation, I felt I should somehow get into a relationship with this girl. I don't know how I loved her and developed feelings towards her. I wanted to get into a relationship with her. I waited for the right moment and one day, I proposed her. My heart literally skipped a beat and I hid my face with my hands, expecting for a reply. She was a very straightforward girl. When I slowly lowered my hands, expecting for a positive reply, she said, "I have only one clause." The clause was, "Everything must be talked to my mother before me." Then I thought, God, who's getting into a relationship? Is it she or her mother? The next evening, I went to her mother to talk about the same. She welcomed me and I started discussing on the same. And she suddenly stood up. I thought she was going to give me a hug and I was very happy. But she was very much similar to her daughter, being very straightforward. She didn't have any words. They were only actions. A bundle of expectations went in vain. Cut. Scene 2. Location: home. I thought love didn't suit me and I wanted to follow my passion of cricket. Ready to face the first ball, bowled in mind. Gloves on, helmet on, buckled up. Through the covers to four. With a fist punch, I was very happy for what I'm doing. Then suddenly, a raindrop fell on my eye. My mother came in with a cup of coffee. Then I woke up into reality. I was dreaming about the next day's game and how I would be playing. Then, as soon as I woke up, I went to the change room, packed my kit, and I was scheduling my travel plan. When everything was going on in full swing, then came in my uncle with a net paper advertisement which said, "IIT Foundation classes for students." All my family members got attracted to that advertisement and they wanted me to take the test, which is tomorrow. I literally begged them, I rolled on the floor, I cried, I ripped, "Mom, please, I don't want to go to this exam, please, I want to play cricket." Result: photocopy of the hall ticket for tomorrow's exam and cancellation of my travel schedule, both were given to me. A bundle of expectations went into vain. Cut. Scene 3. Though I didn't do well in my exam, I don't know how I got selected into that coaching institute. And they were people who literally brainwashed me and eliminated cricket totally out of my mind and induced engineering into my brain. Then I thought, okay, let me do engineering. They brainwashed me so much that, "Preetam, after you take up engineering, it would be a smooth cakewalk. It would be a pretty smooth cakewalk." I thought, okay, let us take up engineering. Then I decided to go and join an engineering college and I did. I wanted to be a very creative engineer and be the one which is rising. But after completing my 2 years of BTech, I understood I was only one in a million. And there are lots of people and I had nothing to do with which is very creative. A bundle of expectations again went into vain. Friends, I've been into various scenarios where in scene 1, I was expecting something from myself. In scene 2, the close people around me expected something from me. And in scene 3, others expected something from me. This is how our life cycle is. And it is a mutual expectation where we expect something to happen and people expect something on us. And life is the expectations of tinted glasses that we wear. Every person has a different perception and each perception differs. I would like to conclude by saying, let us expect less and experience more. Over to the conscious mind.